Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 28th of January. Tension erupts as locals demand agitating farmers to vacate Indian capital's border. Afghanistan's Abdullah offers prisoner release, removal from blacklist to Taliban. And Sri Lanka receives COVID vaccines from India under its neighbourhood first policy. And now for all the details. A mild tension erupted on Thursday as a group of locals staged a counter-protest at India's capital Singhu border with Haryana, demanding the removal of farmers who have been agitating against the agricultural laws for over 2 months. They expressed they were angered over the violence during farmers' tractor rally coinciding with India's Republic Day.
Tension erupted on Thursday as a group of people who claimed to be residents of Singhu village at Indian capital New Delhi's border with Haryana staged a counter-protest and demanded farmers to vacate the area where they have been protesting against new farm laws for over 60 days. The protesters expressed they were angered over the violent clashes between police and farmers who were holding a tractor rally coinciding with India's Republic Day on January 26. The Tuesday's events came even after protest leaders had promised police a massive but peaceful rally along a predetermined route. A section of protesters smashed through barricades and clashed with police and also breached the iconic Red Fort in New Delhi and unfurled their flags at the historic monument.
मेरा हमीदपुर गांव से मैं डेली इनको किसानों को यहां देखता था इनके पास आता था मैं कहीं ना कहीं इनका दर्द समझता था लेकिन 26 जनवरी वाले दिन जो इन्होंने दिल्ली के अंदर दिल्ली पुलिस से कमिटमेंट करके उसका उल्लंघन किया है तिरंगे का अपमान किया है लाल किले पर जाके ये किसान नहीं कर सकता ये भेड़िए है किसान के रूप में
फार्म लीडर्स हैव कंडेम्ड द वायलेंट टर्न द प्रोटेस्ट टुक सेइंग इट हैज अंडरमाइंड देयर कॉज Meanwhile, 16 opposition political parties have announced to boycott President's address in the parliament on Friday in solidarity with the agitating farmers while demanding a probe into Tuesday's violence. On Thursday, India's Interior Minister Amit Shah met nearly 400 injured personnel of the Delhi police undergoing treatment in New Delhi hospitals. Police has arrested at least 19 people and registered over 25 criminal cases in connection with the violence.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Thursday said that the events in eastern Ladakh last year have brought the relationship between India and China at crossroads and the choices made will be profound repercussions not just for two nations but for the world. Speaking during a virtual conference, Jaishankar said the events in Ladakh not only signal disregard for commitments on minimizing troops but also showed willingness to breach peace. His remarks came days after Indian and Chinese troops were involved in a fresh clash at their border in Sikkim last week. Jaishankar reiterated India's stand that any attempt to unilaterally change status quo is completely unacceptable. Border tensions escalated after 20 Indian soldiers died in a violent standoff with the Chinese troops in Himalayan region of Ladakh in June 2020. Since then, both sides have held a series of diplomatic and military talks without any breakthrough so far.
There are discussions underway through various mechanisms on disengagement at the border areas. But if ties are to steady and progress, policies must take into account the learnings of the last 3 decades.
In news from Pakistan. Pakistan will launch its COVID-19 vaccination drive next week, starting with frontline health workers, a government minister Asad Umar said on Wednesday. Pakistan has so far approved 2 vaccines for emergency use, one made by Chinese Sinopharm and the other made by AstraZeneca. The COVID-19 vaccination drive will start in Pakistan next week, starting with frontline health workers, Planning Minister Asad Umar said on Wednesday, as the National Command and Operations Center, NCOC, unveiled a comprehensive plan to administer the vaccine. Asad Umar, who oversees Pakistan's efforts to stem the coronavirus pandemic, said in a tweet, God willing, the vaccination of frontline health workers will start next week. Healthcare workers on Wednesday were making the final touches to converting the Khalik Dina Hall and Library Building in Karachi City into a mass vaccination center.
यहाँ पे ये प्री असेसमेंट एरिया है, यहाँ पे प्री अपने रजिस्ट्रेशन कराएंगे, फिर हमारे डॉक्टर यहाँ पे बैठे होंगे, डॉक्टर उनको देखेंगे कि इनको वैक्सीनेशन लगनी है या नहीं, लगनी भी है या नहीं लगनी, उसके मुताबिक फिर आगे जाके ये हमने 15 क्यूबिकल बनाए हुए हैं, वहाँ पे 15 आदमियों को एट अ टाइम पे हम उनको वैक्सीनेशन करेंगे, फिर उनका हमने वेटिंग एरिया बनाया हुआ है कि माइट भी कोई किसी को कोई रिएक्शन तो नहीं हो रहा है, इसके लिए हमने बेड सपोर्ट वेंटिलेटर को अपना वो भी रखे हुए हैं, मॉनिटर भी रखे हुए हैं.
Pakistan has so far approved 2 vaccines for emergency use, one made by China National Pharmaceutical Group Sinopharm and the other by AstraZeneca. Russia's Sputnik V vaccine is also likely to get similar approval, officials say, adding that the authorizations will be reviewed quarterly with regard to safety, efficacy and quality. Pakistan reported 1,910 new coronavirus cases in 24 hours. Taking the country's COVID-19 tally to 539,387 with 11,514 deaths. Moving on, Pak Sarzabi Party Chairman Syed Mustafa Kamal has said that Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government has been creating future terrorists by not conducting a fear census in Karachi city. He blamed by not recognizing the correct population in the latest census, residents are being deprived of their basic rights.
Pak Sarzameen Party or PSP Chairman Syed Mustafa Kamal earlier this week warned that the Pakistani establishment has been creating future terrorists by not conducting a fair census in Karachi, as he threatened to lock down the city over the move. Addressing a massive protest rally against the acceptance of the National Census 2017 by the Federal Cabinet, Kamal said the census should be declared controversial because if it did not happen, the next 7 generations of Karachi would not be counted correctly, depriving them of their rights, including necessities like water, electricity, gas and jobs.
कल को तुम जब ये शहर के नौजवान इस फ्रस्ट्रेशन में इस जाति पर कल कोई हथियार उठाएगा, उसको रोजगार नहीं मिलेगा, उसको पानी नहीं मिलेगा, उसको दवा नहीं मिलेगी, उसको उसको यहाँ पर ट्रांसपोर्ट नहीं, तो कल को फिर कोई हथियार उठाएगा, तुम आ जाओगे बंदूकें लेकर कि हमने दहशतगर्द मार दिया है, हमने दहशतगर्द पकड़ लिया है, तुम आ जाओगे ऑपरेशन करने, अरे तुम कल के दहशतगर्द आज बना रहे हो.
Kamal further said not a single bus has been given to the city in 13 years. Residents remained silent when Karachi's hospitals, universities and industries were destroyed and when it turned into a pile of garbage, but will no longer sit in silence over the matter of census. He requested the Chief Justice of Pakistan to take notice of the unfair census, which mentions Karachi's population as 16 million instead of 30 million.
In news from Afghanistan, Abdullah Abdullah, chairman of High Council of National Reconciliation in Afghanistan, has offered prisoner release and the removal of Taliban members from the UN blacklist after the Taliban agreed to peace. Abdullah said that several opportunities for bringing peace in the country have been lost, stating that the country cannot afford the current opportunity for peace to be wasted.
Chairman of the High Council of National Reconciliation or HCNR in Afghanistan, Abdullah Abdullah has said that several opportunities for bringing peace in the country have been lost, stating that the country cannot afford the current opportunity for peace to be wasted. Abdullah on Wednesday said that all Taliban prisoners will be freed and the names of the Taliban's members will be removed from the UN blacklist after the Taliban agreed to peace. This comes amid a reported stalemate in the talks between the peace delegations from the Afghan government and the Taliban in Doha. Local media reports have said that the Taliban is reluctant for peace talks due to a lack of international guarantees about the release of their remaining prisoners and the removal of the names of their leaders from the UN blacklist.
Meanwhile, the Taliban's deputy leader, Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar, arrived in Tehran on Tuesday, where he is meeting top Iranian officials, including Foreign Minister Mohammad Javad Zarif. Abdullah Abdullah has said that the Taliban's trip to Tehran was carried out in harmony with the Afghan government. Abdullah stated that Iranian officials have been asked to persuade the Taliban for a ceasefire and to settle the disputed issues with the Afghan government.
More on news from Afghanistan. A female break dancer in Afghanistan is shattering barriers by being the first trained dancer in such a unique form. 18-year-old Maniza Talash in Afghan capital Kabul joined a small but ardent breakdancing community in the country a few months ago, but now aims to represent her country in one of the latest sports to be admitted to the Olympics.
At a gym in Afghanistan's downtown Kabul, Maniza Talash and her teammates jump and sway to the beat, working up a sweat, breakdancing and doing head spins. When Talash first joined the breakdancing club about 2.5 months ago, there were no girls there. Now 5 other girls have followed her lead. Doing the 6-step or head spin is a far cry for a young girl in war-torn Afghanistan, where women were not allowed to receive education or leave the house without a male relative up until 2001 under the Taliban's ultra-hardline rule. But opposition and threats remain.
بریکینگ تمرین میکنم مدت 2.5 ماه میشه و به خاطر که علاقه زیاد داشتم به این رشته اومدم تا یک الگوی خوب باشم در افغانستان.
نظر من خیلی خوب است که بانوانم بتونن داخل این چون مثلا ورزشی این چون رشته ای عزیب بعد کار بکنن. ما 4 سال دیگه وقت داریم که دخترای زیادی رو داخل افغانستان تربیت کنیم تا سال 2024 بتونیم حداقل یک دختر یا دو دختر به عنوان ورزشکار رشته بریکینگ برای جامعه جهانی ما معرفی بکنیم.
The Lashes Club in Kabul, founded by a few local breakers a year ago, now has over 30 members who train 3 days a week to learn the finer points of a dance style that has evolved into a sport. Apart from having to overcome social hurdles, the Lash has to brace for tough physical training, but she is determined.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka on Thursday received a huge consignment containing 500,000 doses of Covishield vaccines manufactured by Serum Institute of India under the Vaccine Maitri initiative. Countries who have received a supply of COVID-19 vaccines from India under Neighbourhood First policy include Bhutan, Maldives, Nepal, Myanmar, Sri Lanka, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. Sri Lanka on Thursday received the first batch of coronavirus vaccine dispatched by India in the latest move by New Delhi to donate millions of vaccine doses to its South Asian neighbours. Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa received the consignment packed in 42 boxes at Bandara Naike International Airport. Taking to Twitter, he thanked Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and people of India for generosity shown to people of Sri Lanka at this time in need. The vaccines are part of India's Vaccine Maitri or Vaccine Friendship Initiative, and these have also been gifted vaccines to 7 other countries in the region. Meanwhile, vaccination process in the island nation is set to commence from Friday. Sri Lanka, a country of 20 million population, has so far reported 60,694 COVID-19 cases with 290 deaths. The vast majority of the production of the 3 most widely approved COVID-19 vaccines, including the AstraZeneca drug, has so far been snapped up by developed nations. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.